Hello students, welcome to maths class. Today I am going to solve very important topic, that is test of divisibility. Okay, let us learn some examples. So if I take the number 18, whether it is divisible by 2 or not, then what can I do? I have divided, see, 18 by 2. Then 2 overs are 18, then 2 nines are 18. 18 minus 18 is 0. If the remainder remains 0, then it is exactly divisible by 2. So that means it is exactly divisible. Okay, then if I take one more example, 15 is divided by 2. Then 15 by 2. 2 how much is 15? 2 sevens are 14. 15 minus 14 is 1. If the remainder remains, then it is not divisible. Okay, this is not so time consuming, right? If I take one more example, 4, 3, 5, 7, 6, 4, 7, 2. Whether it is divisible by 2, then if you want to do so, it's a lengthy process, right? Then what you have to do? You have to find some shortcut methods. So today in this class, let us learn some shortcut methods, that is nothing but test of divisibility. Okay, so now which all divisibility we have to learn here? Divisibility by 10, divisibility by 5, then divisibility by 2, then 3 and 9. Let us learn it one by one. So now first about divisibility by 10. Nothing but 10 table. Okay, so 10, 20, 30, 40, like this. Okay, so these are multiples of 10. Then if I take non-multiple of 10, such as 30, 50, 37, 53. So what is the difference between these two? Here, each number ends with a digit 0. But here, number is not ends with a digit 0. That means multiple of 10 are divisible by 10. So this, is this divisible by 10 then? No, it is not divisible by 10. Then what is the meaning of divisibility by 10? Is nothing but any number ends with a digit 0. Then that number is exactly divisible by 10. So can I write a statement of that? Okay, so now a number is divisible by 10 if its ones digit is 0. So can you give example now? Okay, example, children, 5 0 3 0, is it divisible by 10? Yes. Why? The number ends with the digit 0, so it is divisible by 10. If I take 4550, is it divisible by 10? Yes. Number ends with a digit 0, so it is divisible by 10. So 4353, is it divisible then? No. Why? It's not ending with a digit 0. So this is not divisible by 10. Okay, after learning the divisibility by 10, let us learn divisibility by 5. So what is divisibility by 5 then? Suppose if you take the multiple of 5 in 5 neighborhood, this 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, then 5 4s are 20. Okay, so here what you can observe, each number ends with a digit 0 or 5, 0 or 5, alternatively it is 0 or 5, then such numbers are divisible by 5. Okay, so then what is the meaning of divisibility by 5? Then it is, if the ones digit of a number is 0 or 5, then it is divisible by 5. Suppose if I take the example 4355, ends with a digit 5, so then it is divisible by 5, right? So then 5400, is it divisible by 5? Yes, ends with the digit 0, then it is divisible by 5. Then 1234, is it divisible by 5? No, then it is not divisible by 5, since the last number is not 0 or 5. So like this way you can understand divisibility by 5. Now let us learn divisibility by 2. Divisibility by 2. Children, what are even numbers? Can you list all even numbers now? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay? Then say some odd numbers. This 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Another list of odd numbers. Okay? Here, which digit ends with the digit that is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10? Means last number is 0. Then it is exactly divisible by 2, means multiple of 2 is exactly divisible by 2. Then is this divisible by 2, children? Okay, the number ends with 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 are not divisible by 2. Then what is the divisibility by 2 rule says? It is right. If the ones digit, of a number, ones digit of a number is either 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Then the number, is divisible by two. Let us take some examples. Example 342 ends with the digit 2. Yes, then it is divisible by 2. That means all even numbers are divisible by 2. So if I take 3400, is it divisible by 2? Yes, ends with the digit 0, so it is divisible by 2. Then 4559, is it divisible by 2? No, it is not, ends with the digit 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So it is not divisible by 2. Then after learning divisibility by 2, let us move to divisibility by 3 and 9. Divisibility by 3 and 9. Okay, then what is divisibility by 3 or 9 says? So method is same. Let's see here. If I take one example here, 3, 5, 7, 3. Okay, so then what is divisibility by 3 says here? How to see the sum of this. Okay, so 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 3. What is the answer? 3 plus 5, 8. 8 plus 10 is 18. So then 18, is it divisible by 3 children? Yes, it is divisible by 3. As well as 18 is also divisible by 9. That means 3, 5, 7, 3 is divisible by 3 as well as 9. Okay, so let us take one more example to understand this. Seven, six. Okay, so just add it here. 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 6. What is the answer? 3 plus 5, 8. 8 plus 7, 15. 15 plus 6, 21. Okay, so 21, is it divisible by 3? Yes. But 21, is it divisible by 9? No. That means 3, 5, 7, 6 is divisible by 3 but not by 9. Then what is the rule says here? What is divisibility by 3 and 9? Let us learn here. So divisibility by 3 statement. A number is divisible by 3 if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3. Okay, this is about a number is divisible by 3 if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3. So what example can we give? So 3, 5, 7, 6 is an example for this one. Okay, so then what is divisibility by 9? Same statement, a number is divisible by 9 if the sum of the digits is divisible by 9. This is about divisibility by 3 as well as 9. The method is same children. Okay, after learning this, let us see some more example problems. Dear children, please note all these points in your maths notebook. Let us see some more example problems. The divisibility of 2, 1, 4, 6, 5, 8, 7 by 3. Okay? So check the divisibility of 2, 1, 4, 6, 5, 8, 7 by 3. So what method you have to follow, children? After learning divisibility rule, we can follow the same method. What is the method? Just the sum of these numbers. Let us see the sum of these numbers. 2 plus 1 plus 4 plus 6 plus 5 plus 8 plus 7. Okay, so add it now. 2 plus 1 plus 4 plus 6 plus 5 plus 8 plus 7. So what is the answer? 7 plus 8, 15. 15 plus 5, 20. 20 plus 6, 26. 26 plus 4, 30. 30 plus 1, 31. 31 plus 2, 33. Is it divisible by 3? So 33 is divisible by 3. How much are 3? 11 is 33. Okay? So like this we can find the answer. So let us see one more problem, example problem. Example, check the divisibility by 9. Which is the number there? 1, 5, 2, 8, 7, 5. 1, 5, 2, 8, 7, 5. Is it divisible by 9? Let us see now. What is the rule say, student? You have to add all the terms. Okay, let's add and see. 1 plus 5 plus 2 plus 8 plus 7 plus 5. So what is the answer? 1 plus 5, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. 8 plus 8, 16. 16 plus 7, 23. 23 plus 5. 28. Clear, children? Is it 28? Is it coming in 9 table? So, is it divisible by 9? No. 28 is not divisible by 9. So, 28 is not divisible by 9. Okay? So, 28 is not divisible by 9. Then, therefore, 1 5, 2, 8, 7, 5 is not divisible by 9. Okay, so then let us see one more problem. If the 3-digit number 2, 4, x is divisible by 9, then what is the value of x? What is the value of x? Again, same method. See, if the 3-digit number, this is a 3-digit number, 2, 4, x is a 3-digit number. In this, it is divisible by 9. The condition given, that is, it is divisible by 9. Then what is the value of x? Here you can find an x. That value you have to find out. So here, value of x should be a 1-digit number. Okay, if it is 2-digit number, it will become a 2, 4. If it is 2-digit, it will become a 4-digit number. So we want x value should be a 1-digit number, single-digit number. Should we find the value of x now? Okay. So what the rule says is that 2, 4, x is divisible by 9. 2, 4, x is divisible by 9. So when it is divisible by 9, what rule do you have to follow? Same rule. It's a sum you have to see. 2 plus 4 plus x. Okay? So then 2 plus 4 plus x is how much? 2 plus 4 is 6 plus x. Okay, so then 6 plus x is also divisible by 9, right? Then what are the possible values of this? So it can be 9 or 18. Okay, is divisible by 9 means is 9 multiple of 9 can write. So 9, 18 or 27, that is continuous. So then what is the value of x so that we can get the answer 9 or 18 or 27? Let us see. Now let us see first. So x or x 6, if I add how much it will become 9. Then 6 plus 3 is equal to 9. It means it is exactly divisible, right? So then what is the value of x? How can I find? See here. 6 plus x is equal to 9. So then x is equal to 9 minus 6. How much 9 minus 6 is? 3. Then see, what is the value of x? X can be 3 here. If x is 3, what it will become? 6 plus 3, 9. Exactly divisible by 9, right? Okay, suppose if I take the value of 6 plus x is equal to 18. Okay? Then what is the value of x then? X is equal to 18 minus 6. What is the value of 18 minus 6 is? 12. So is it possible, children? Is it possible? No, no. Already I said x should be a single digit number. But I got the value of x is 2 digit. So it is not possible. And which is the possible value of x? Possible value of x is equal to. Therefore, x is equal to 3. Okay? That's all about the example problems. In the next class, we will learn exercise of test of divisibility. Till then, take care. Thank you.